These are 5 things to buy before you buy your next camera. Yes, I know how it feels. A new camera body launches and you just have to get it. Some magical spec in there is apparently going to make you a better creative, a better filmmaker, a better content creator. For some reason, we just feel that we need it. And it's the furthest thing from the truth. Now, honestly, your money is far better spent elsewhere. And today I'm going to show you 5 things that I feel you're better off spending your money on than buying that next camera body. Number 1, a camera cage and side handle. Now, you're probably thinking to yourself, why? Well, point 2 will start making sense too. But honestly, a side handle not only widens your grip when you do hold your camera, but it creates a lot of extra mounting points, which allows you to attach things to start making better content. All of this gives you more stable and creative footage. Now, although a side handle and a cage is pretty much the bare minimum for building an epic rig, it all pretty much starts there, and these are the most essential pieces that truly make the largest difference. I've done a whole video on kind of making a camera rig, and I'll link it up here as well as in the comments below, and if you want to watch it after this video, you can. Number 2, buying a really decent camera monitor. Now, at first you're probably thinking, well, I've been using the little screen that flips out on my camera for years, and I definitely don't need a camera monitor. Another big lie. I use the OC T7 monitor, which is a 7-inch monitor. Now, I have quite a few monitors. I have a 7-inch Field World, I've got a Best View 5.5-inch, and honestly, the OC T7 is amazing due to the fact that it's 3000 nits brightness. So in bright daylight, this thing stands out and you can see it. Now, if you're thinking, well, I don't normally film in daylight, that's not what a camera monitor is actually for. By having a larger monitor, you're able to not only frame your picture better, but you're also able to see your composition, your color, everything that's going on in the shot, and you start noticing the things in the shot that you didn't notice on that little monitor. You know when you take a shot and afterwards you see there's a fire hydrant in the back and you didn't see it? That's what camera monitors help for as well. A 7-inch or a decent camera monitor is one of those things that once you've used it, you'll never be able to not use one again. And every time you do just take out your camera and use the side screen, you feel this kind of hindrance, something that's holding you back in your creative freedom. Number 3, buying a gimbal. Now, this is probably a hot topic because of stabilization in cameras nowadays, and most people honestly do not know how to use a gimbal or why you should even own a gimbal. The problem is with camera stabilization, it only gives you about 2 to 3 steps of stabilization. Once you start walking further than that, or your movement is kind of limited, you start seeing that camera shake. Now, I know camera shake is a good thing in certain instances, and I'm not telling you to shoot an entire project on a gimbal. However, what you're gonna see in item number 5 relates back to pretty much what I'm telling you now about a gimbal. It changes the viewer's brain's perception of automatically predicting how the next shot will look. And by creating this handheld to perfectly glide in shots, like you see in movies, it really changes the outcome of your final project or your creative video. A gimbal is something that you have to have in your kit. It's not something that you have to use on every single shoot. And I've done that plenty of times. I've shot an entire wedding on just a gimbal. I've shot entire shoots with no gimbal. But there are times when you have to have that gimbal with you, and that is why the gimbal makes it to my top 5. Number 4, decent lighting. This is probably the biggest part that is kind of avoided when it comes to being a creative or a filmmaker. The problem is people are very scared about lighting because they don't understand lighting. Once you understand lighting, you can use lighting to manipulate the picture that you want, giving you some form of direction and change in your go-to shot. The problem is if you're not using lighting, you're pretty much just capturing what is there. And if I can capture what's just there, so can you, and as long as you're shooting on the same lens, everything's going to look the same. But with creative lighting, it allows you to manipulate your scene and be creative and deliver something to your client that no one has ever seen before. Now, I've done some cool videos with some Nanlite, and I honestly love Nanlite products. I think a lot of it is just due to the fact that they make very good lights and they're able to change not just your Kelvin or RGB, but you can change your green and magenta. So you can really dial in the look that you want to. So if you haven't invested in some good lighting, I suggest you do. It allows you to be completely creative. You can do product shoots, you can do model shoots, you can create scenes. Perhaps there's a scene on a project that really just doesn't look so good, but you really want that angle. Adding light into it just kind of fills the blanks and kind of gives you that style that you're looking for. Number five, glass or lenses. Now, most people don't really understand how important a lens is. I know a lot of people just kind of shoot on one lens and they say, this lens is so versatile, you can shoot everything with this lens. Now, to a point, I do agree. You can shoot a lot on something like the 20-40-70 lenses or the 12-35 or the 18-35 when it's speed boosted onto the GH5 system. But the problem is you're doing the same types of shot with the same type of compression. Now, compression is something that's really important when it comes to a shot, and it changes your viewer's perception of the shot. And going back to the gimbal that I was talking about, changing that prediction of what the next shot is going to look like is really what makes your video stand out. So if you haven't invested in a super wide lens yet to get these immersive shots and kind of show a place different than anyone else could, or maybe a telephoto lens and you can get that massive compression and just kind of bring your background right up behind the subject, but still blurring it out. And if you're watching any creative video, they are constantly changing lenses or their focal length to change the viewer's perception of what the scene would normally look like. So those are my five recommendations to look at when buying a new camera. Instead of just buying that new camera, try and invest in some other types of gear. I'm very fortunate enough to kind of give you this advice. I own a ton of different types of gear. I do have four camera bodies, which is absurd probably, but I do have a lot of different camera rigs and monitors and lights. And honestly, it's the only reason why my videos tend to be creative as opposed to where I was maybe 3-4 years ago. And if you look at my content that I create now, I hope you enjoyed the video. Hit the like button, subscribe button, and drop a comment below. Let me know what is your next piece of gear that you're going to be buying. And if it is a camera, let me know anyway. Thanks for watching. Wherever you are in the world, have a good day, good evening, good night. Goodbye.